Sakaki Norisa, ikimasu!
Hello again, ladies and gentlemen. Saka here with another episode of Fallout 4 Far Harbor. When we last left off, Chiyo and Nick Valentine found the terminal with Dima's memories on it, but when we try to unlock it, the auxiliary power is off and the computer simulation interface is offline, which means we need to do some digging. Try to turn this beast on. All right. Something tells me.
Sentient life. Alert level elevated.
Oh! The Dominator. Oh geez. Oh geez. Oh geez. Oh geez. All right. Let us grab a stim pack, and then we will med up. Let's take some Med-X to get some of that damage resistance. Let's take some Jet. Oh, and then we will swap to our shotgun and just lay into this Assaultron Dominator. Die!
Not that it's not.
Ooh! Okay, we're hidden. Everything is good. Everything is nice. Let's take some rad away. Get those rads out. Okay, don't need all that stuff. Okay, now I see why they put that first aid kit down there. Sweet, more ammunition. And now because of our life giver perk, we are able to regenerate health while we wait. And here we go, it seems. We got the password. So we have one memory locked. Icebreaker override. Oh. And it's doing a load. Okay, so apparently we're in this guy's head. Let's store these code blocks if we can.
If you're listening to this, then you made it inside my memory banks. Take a moment. I know it's a lot at once.
Okay. What happens? Oh! That wasn't good. Experimentation. No, we do not want to exit the simulation. So we've got our code blocks.
The architecture you're seeing is data.
Oh, and we can
data.
Jump massively.
Into the chair.
I don't think we're getting weight, so we'll store all these code blocks that we possibly can.
I see. You're using an earlier version of that technology, a brainwave scanner instead of a direct neural wire. Look around. Do you see that yellow column in the distance? That's long-term memory storage. That's your goal. But you
All
can't
right.
just retrieve that data yourself. One of the programs loaded in that holotape is called the Indexer. They're represented by the friendly green sprites milling around. Do you see them? The indexers have one purpose, to get the data in the yellow column and bring it back to the memory access point. You need to help them get there and back safely. Once they've recovered all the data in the memory, the program will translate it into something you can understand. If you ever need to leave the simulation, then don't worry. Nothing gets reset. You can keep going from wherever you left off.
Handy. No. So what do we do here?
Good. Now you just need to create a path to the data with code blocks, and your indexers can get to work.
Okay, the indexers. So these little bugs Need to get to the mainframe. I see, I see. I got you, I got you. Is there pathing good enough? Come on, buddies. Yeah, there you go. So we're helping these bugs along, it seems. Okay. Definitely a fascinating break from the norm. Come on, you idiot bugs. Get across. All right. Now, me being paranoid, I want to store these code blocks because they don't need them anymore. I can just jump the gaps. And once everyone is safely across, come on, there you go. Go ahead and path. Alrighty then. Come on, get over there. Everybody, let's go. Move, hustle. There they go. Oh, they're shooting my little guys.
To your presence. Now things will get hairier.
There you go.
You'll need to deploy defense constructs against the system's active countermeasures.
Which it looks like I did.
The sentries will do everything they can to stop your indexers from returning to the access point with the data.
All right. Oh, crap. Can I build them up here? I can. Well, I would be able to. Build! What are you doing? Shoot them! Where are they coming from? Oh, and of course, since they're all dead, they appear over there. Okay. Well, I've got a pretty good defense here.
They need to return to the access point.
Okay. This is going to be pretty tedious, if I do say so myself. And I do. Let's store you. Actually, let's put you over here to take care of these guys that may pop up. Oh, you got one right there, guy. All right. So it looks like one there is good enough.
Indexers get back safely to the access point with the data.
Yes. Looks like we need some more turrets. That one turret may not be able to do the work. All right, so they've got that pretty much covered. I'll store this guy and move him right here so they can take care of whatever pops up along the wall. It's sort of like a tower defense. Luckily, I don't think these guys have very many hit points.
Make sure the indexers have a safe path back to the access point.
Yes, they will. I think we've got a pretty solid setup here. So these are good. They'll continue to fight. The bugs will work their way around, and they will be good to go.
Warning, data breach detected.
It may be a breach, but we've got our defense turrets going to work.
Your job is to help the indexers return to the access point with
yep.
the data.
Oh, those! I tell you, once they get that data, they're scooting along pretty well. That guy still needs to get there. Aha! How's my other boys doing? Alright, so far so good. He's gonna make it back. Alright, 40%. 60%.
Memory retrieval now at 60%.
That'll be 80% and 100%. Then I think we can finally exit
Sentry
the simulation.
Sentry initiating erasure of intrusive indexer.
So do they just keep going then? That should be it.
Verifying memory file. 100%. We're done here.
Sweet.
We now...
What?
I'll have an access point into the next memory. Just step into the data stream where this memory was stored.
Okay, so we do the next.
0V-9AX0. Converted to audio transcription. Beginning playback.
Things are not going well with Far Harbor. Several of my people have been assaulted, spat at, interrogated for no reason.
Alright, so we got something brand new.
But there's still a chance they can learn.
We have five of those and no data blocks.
We just need one of their own who's on our side. I can't let anyone know what I'm about to do. I'll need to set up the equipment far away from Acadia. It'll double as a place to bury the evidence.
Additional location data appended. A makeshift medical facility underneath the Vim. Pop factory. Coordinates downloaded.
Alright, so now we have Dima's secret medical facility ready to go. I'm storing all of these code blocks. Can't be too stingy. Yep, store it all. Now, where are we trying to get to? What is going on? All right, so that's the firewall. Where is the laser? All right, so it's going down through here and hitting that block. Now once it hits that, it'll feed the beam all through that and shoot it through there. Whew, we're like walking on the moon here. Alright, so it shoots that beam through those. We need a redirect here. Whoops. There we go. We need a redirect to go that way. Like so. Then we need to pull that one off. That'll shoot through there. Deactivate the firewall. We got another firewall here. And of course, some more blocks to grab. And it looks like we need another redirect block, which is right here. Decoder relay. So what we need to do is build up. Right here. And then shoot the decoder relay this way. Yes? Sweet action. And then we just, I want to sort of get turrets set up, ready to go, like there, and say there. And say here.
Sentry has detected active intrusive program.
You darn right, we're intrusive. Okay, so it looks like these guys. Okay. Please tell me. I think they said when they exit, nothing changes. That would be a massive pain in the rear end if it did. Yeah, that's what I thought. I had a feeling there was going to be some sentries here. We sort of need to protect them on their way back. Like that, perhaps? Hoping. Now, we can't get out of construction mode without exiting the program. Thank you, no physics. So that means... let's go ahead and start laying down a path.
Beginning attrition of intrusive program.
There we go, path is set. These turrets should start doing the work. waiting for more sentries to pop up.
Intrusive program detected.
Yeah, it looks like that turret's keeping them busy. And then as all these boys get back, 20, 40, 60, 80.
Intrusion detected. Countermeasures initiated.
Whoo, look at them run.
Intrusive program detected.
All right. I'm thinking once this boy is good to go, we hightail it back. Make sure our little mites are making it back to the mainframe.
First data block recovered.
Yay!
Good. Just keep doing what you're doing.
Oh, I'm doing what I'm doing. We've got a nice turret defense set up here.
Sentry beginning erasure protocol against unauthorized indexer.
All right. This is 80%.
Another data block retrieved.
We're just waiting on our last boy. Here he comes. Go, buddy, go. I'm gonna call you Timmy. No, go that way, Timmy. Sweet action. And little Timmy will finish off the memory.
Memory retrieval at 100%. Verifying. Looks good. You can now use the data stream as an access point. The next memory.
All right, in we go.
Identification 0J-2NN8. Converted to audio transcription. Beginning playback.
I'm offloading this memory. I cannot bear lying to Confessor Martin and his children of Adam any longer. Better to just forget.
Yellow!
I found it. The location of the launch key to fire the nuclear missile inside the submarine. Confessor Martin believes it can bring his people into division. Destruction at the hands of an atomic blast. He struggles with how literal his interpretation of that precept should be. I can't risk him deciding to find the key and use it. His people were the first to accept me for what I am.
Sweet.
The thought of them being gone fills
me with nothing but pain. I don't care about Kingspore Lighthouse.
Additional data appended. Location, the Harbor Grand Hotel safe room. Key code, 485130.
Sweet, I think we've got some nuclear launch codes. Now are we ready to go? Well, okay. Yes, let's exit the simulation. Or not, was that wrong? Are we back to the computer? Well, at least I think it may have saved our progress so we can access the next memory straight from the computer and not have to go through the mite direction. Certainly an interesting aspect of the game, and I can see where people were saying, you know, why in the world? Whoa, Nick. Excuse me, buddy. I need to get back in here. Yep. Our next memory acquired, here we go, 30 XP. On to the next memory. All right, here we are then, taking a look around. That's where the data stream is coming from. The mites are ready to go. This looks like a good defensible spot for a turret. But by the time they come through here, they're already going to be there, so I'll save the rest of the turrets. Store these code blocks. I wonder who came up with the bright idea to let's use the build mode to represent a computer. Alright, that firewall is good. Storing this code block. Matter of fact, it looks like this would be a good place to store defenses. Alright, so that... here we go. I think. Nope, that's where we need to hit. Yeah, that's where we need to hit. Do we have a redirect block somewhere? Oh, we can go around? This is trippy as all get out. go around here. See if we can find a redirect block somewhere. How about this? Okay. Any other code blocks? So they're gonna be going this way. What happens if we touch the firewall? Can we touch the firewall? Oh, it acts as a wall, like a literal wall. Okay.
Intrusive program detected.
I am not an intrusive program. I'm here to help. All right, where in the world would these redirect blocks be? I probably passed it. Because I'm an idiot. Let's jump over here.
Sentry, beginning erasure protocol against unauthorized indexer.
Yeah, they can try. I got a turret. Alright, my mites are ready to go. There has to be some sort of redirect block around here somewhere. Am I just an idiot? Am I missing it? That's very likely.
Sentry has detected active intrusive program.
Yeah, that sentry's getting lit up. This has to be it, right? No. Can I jump up in there with some crafty jumping?
Sentry has detected active intrusive program.
Yeah. Almost. I think that is where I have to go. If not, I'm gonna break the game. It is a Bethesda game after all. Sweet. So we got some more code blocks. And there's the redirect block. The decoder relay. Alrighty. So it's coming right above here. We'll go one, two. Yep, and then the redirect block will point this way, like so. Nope. All right, let's move these bad boys over then. Store those. Go one more. Oops. If this looks tedious, believe me, it is. And skadoosh. Oh, one more. I know count. I know good with math. So now, yeah, this row right here. So right there. And two. And the redirect block goes there. Store the code block and the code block. That will shoot that. Bring the firewall down, and look at that. We've got all kinds of redirects. So you go there. Holy gravy at the code blocks. I'm glad I'm not, like, weighed down with all this stuff. It is just bits and bobs. Yes, store everything. I wish I could just click and drag. Store everything. Alright, so now I need to move it two over from the center. Alright, from the center.
Sentry initiating erasure.
Right here. Alright, so this is our next destination. There. And there. And there. So that activated that. So then that beam goes up, gets shot across the roof. Making progress.
No!
Really? No, don't exit the simulation. We've got it. Alright, up and over, up and over. Alright, this is where we're going. We need to point that sucker right here. There. and there. Nope. Thank you for firing and letting me know I was one off. There and there. And then we'll redirect her. Right. Yeah.
Sentry initiating erasure of intrusive indexer.
Nope, I didn't turn it. Like that. Alright, path is now clear, so it's time to put down some guns. Can this boy do the work from here? That'd be really cool if you could. But probably not. I'm not gonna chance it. Oh, crap! No, don't end the simulation. Alright, so we have a turret there to stop those guys.
Sentry has detected active intrusive program.
So we'll be good there. And then we just need some turrets this way. I don't know what the range on these things are. How about there? Can you hit them from there?
Attrition of intrusive program.
You can. Now, are they going to pop up anywhere else? I'm feeling like a second gun here might do some good. And I'm feeling a second gun down here will be good because in the hallway they'll be protected. So we'll just put her right there.
Beginning erasure protocol against unauthorized
indexer. Alright, let's work backwards and start putting our command blocks in. Alright, straight and narrow. We've got 20 blocks, so I don't think we're going to run out anytime soon. You there, you there, you there, you there, you there. And alright, boys. Let's go, little mites. You're good. You've got two pretty well straight shots at him. No, don't get confused and turned around. Looks like our guns are doing the work over yonder. These guys are doing the work over here. Our mites are making their way downtown. Come on. Off you go.
Sentry initiating erasure of intrusive indexer.
Yeah, we got two guns there doing the work from this side. So their path should be cleared. That one gun there is doing the work.
Intrusive program detected.
Let's go, little mites. Retrieve those memories. It's like they get scared whenever the turrets start shooting. They're like, nope, don't move. If we don't move, they won't see us. There's some coming back with the memories. Come on, shuttle bus, shuttle bus.
Data breach detected. Initiating.
No, your pathing is all off. Go straight and narrow. He's all over the place. That must be the drunk mite.
Intrusive.
All right, sweet.
Detected.
Let's go. Those turrets are doing the work. 20%. I think we're in the clear here. Come on, come on, come on. Those mites have already delivered their payload. These guys, come on.
Beginning erasure protocol against unauthorized indexer.
What's your problem, dude?
Another data block retrieved. One more to
go. Shoot, that one's probably going to get the data, get back, and come back before that one even gets there. Come on your horse, boy. There you go.
Complete memory retrieved. The data stream is now available to access the next memory.
File identification 0H-3X0P. Converted to audio transcription. Beginning playback.
I've made a contingency plan in case Far Harbor discovers the truth or gives in to their xenophobia despite all my efforts. I've isolated the wind turbine powering Far Harbor's fog condensers. A kill switch command will leave them defenseless from the fog and its creatures. But now that it's done, am I really capable of this? This massacre that I've engineered? I'm going to remove the command code from my memories. I'll bury a hard copy if I need to use it. But I can't keep it close to me. It makes me sick.
All right, so a new place.
Coordinates to the kill switch command and the wind farm maintenance building.
So we have a new map update, but let's hop out of the simulation. We've definitely got some things to do. We've learned a little bit about Dima. A longer episode. Not a whole lot went on as far as the grand scheme of things. But if we look at our data, we can recover the wind kill farm switch code, the nuclear launch key, retrieving the memories, a secret facility. We've got tons of things to do to see what this guy's motivations are. But that is going to do it for me in this episode of Fallout 4. I may go ahead and just do the other couple memories off camera. You've seen how that works. And then come back to you when we're ready to exit this place and see if the Children of Adam will like us. So that'll do it for me. This has been Sokka for Chio. Like, share, and subscribe if you are so bold. And I will see you in the next Fallout 4 video. Take care.